Hey there, bastards. Before this video starts, real quick, I just want to say that I was a little distracted by my dog while I was doing this reaction. So I didn't say everything I wanted to say, and I missed a lot of stuff in the video. But now, since my dog is sleeping, you can see her foot right there, I'll have little snippets where I interject and add more commentary and say things I was wanting to say when I originally did the reaction. So that's all I want to say. Okay, bye.
So we're going to take this look at this new MMO, all right? And this is what I was wanting to do earlier, but my dog was being annoying. I've already signed up for the alpha, believe it or not. And this game is apparently supposed to be like a community-driven and social. They focus a lot on the social elements of this MMO. And it looks cool, but there's so many MMOs that say this stuff. It's like all garbage until it actually comes out. Basically, welcome to a vast social sandbox MMO inspired by the legends of the medieval era. Here, myths are real, ghosts exist, and magic is unquestioned. In this immense open world playground, you choose the role you want to play. How many times have you heard that? Immerse yourself along with thousands of other players as you explore the lands, build your home, forge your reputation, and craft your own stories. So we're going to watch this. There's an 8.5 minute an official announcement of the RPG that I was just talking about. I don't even know how to say the name of this. Pax Dia. Is that how you say it? I don't know.
It's the game that many of us have been...
Okay, turn the subtitles.
...practicing throughout our professional careers to make.
Okay, are you going to show us actual gameplay?
The team is building this game because this is the game that we've been wanting to play for a very long time.
Yeah, I mean, we've been talking about this project for 20 years almost.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
So just by the way they're talking, it's already giving me a very Ashes of Creation kind of visionary vibe, because the head honcho in charge of like Ashes of Creation said the exact same thing. Like, this is an MMO that he's been wanting to work on for a long time. I want to make the MMO that I've always wanted to play. So yeah, it's already a good thing that they're making a game that they want to play. They're not trying to appease the masses. They're not trying to follow trends, which means hopefully that'll reflect in the gameplay and we'll get a lot of new features that we've never seen before in an MMO. 20 years?
We feel we're creating a common dream here, which is bigger than our own. Pax Dia is very much what you want it to be. It's a world.
Hang on, dude. Are they gonna go through this whole 8 minute video and only show us concept art?
Pax Dia is very much what you want it to be. It's a world. It's a place which is real, feels real. It's always there. But most importantly, you're there with other people. And that's really what the sandbox is all about. It is about maximizing human interaction in a meaningful way. And we feel, you know, this is the holy grail in MMO design.
So is this going to be PvP is on always, or how is this going to work? Because a lot of times when like these developers come out and say like, yeah, we want player to player interaction to mean something and everything like that, a lot of times it means like PvP is always on.
Just to expand on that thought a little bit, I don't think they're actually talking about PvP here. I think they're talking about literally what they said, player-to-player interaction, making sure every player feels important in the world, no matter what they enjoy doing. You know, some players don't really like to do PvP or like dungeons or raids. They just like to craft and farm and do stuff like that. And making sure players have a way to do what they like doing while also feeling important in the world. I think that's really cool. But then again, if PvP is always going to be on, you know, players are free to do what they want. A lot of MMOs, it quickly devolves into just high-level players trolling low-level players, killing them, you know, stuff like that. So I hope they have a way to counter gameplay like that.
Or maybe they'll have certain activities, like in the open world, that other players have to join in on. I have no idea. This just showed up in my recommended today, and I thought it would be a cool thing to react to because I've never heard about this game or anything about this game until today.
So the name of the game, Pax Dia, like we're calling it the Divine Peace, and it's based on around the idea the way we're constructing the world is as a new player, you start in what we're calling the Heartlands. So these are safe valleys in which you're allowed.
Ooh, we do get some gameplay. So you start in a place called the Heartlands, and I'm guessing this is like No PvP, like this is your safe area, basically.
To build with your friends and form the communities and do a lot of crafting, have your villages in. And these are like the peaceful areas that are guaranteed to like not be very dangerous. So you're gonna be in relative safety when you're in these areas.
They're doing some base building right here, just making a little home or a shack, and I'm guessing they're setting up like a little shop where they're crafting armor and building it, and that'll be really cool seeing player-built homes just all around populating the world. But I wonder if you can only build stuff like this in the safe zone Heartlands, or if you can just build it anywhere in the world, even if it's not necessarily a safe zone to build. And if you do choose to build your shop in like a not a very safe zone, that could add a whole new gameplay element where you can, you know, pay higher level players or maybe some mercenaries to guard your little settlement or your shop wherever you're set up at if it's not in the safe zone. So right here, she's got a little tier one alchemy bench. She's grinding up some ingredients to make some potions. So this is like a little alchemy shop that players can, you know, if they're traveling through, you can stop here, buy some potions off of them, and then go about your way.
Crafting, have your villages in, and these are like the peaceful areas that are guaranteed to like not be very dangerous. So you're going to be in relative safety when you're in these areas.
So we have modularity built in and how we do the visuals of it. The good thing about doing it that way is that we also then give the players and the crafting part of our game a lot of flexibility and customizability. And we're pushing this very, very far for PAX Day.
Okay, well, so crafting is going to be like a big part of it.
We offer a character which has multiple different layers. So depending on what type of game you as a player want to play, you can combine these items.
Ooh, hang on, let me look at this. I mean, this is already looking like, if the game released with this inventory system, I wouldn't mind at all. Very minimalistic, and I kind of like that in my games anyways. Like, especially in MMOs, I'll always download plugins to make the UI more minimalistic. I don't like 100 alerts and crowded with DPS meters and stuff on my screen. I just want it real simple, man.
Which has specific stats.
The thing that I'm most proud about this game is the procedural costume.
The armor we've seen so far isn't too crazy. It's very based in reality.
The thing that I'm most proud about this game is the procedural costume and surface generated and I made for character art, which is a procedural way of controlling the metals and leathers in the game, how they behave and how they look.
All of it is meant to at least be to some extent historically accurate.
Right here he's showing how like the armor gets damaged and stuff like that. I wonder if that's like damage that you can, you know, when you get hit, your armor will start to get more damaged until you get it repaired. Or maybe this is like beginner lower tier armor. It's like rusted and beat up, kind of like what they're showing here. But if you upgrade it or refine it, it'll get like more shiny and well built.
It goes extremely in depth and it offers a lot of visual variety.
That's cool. Wait, does this mean there's going to be like, you can see visually when your armor gets damaged and stuff? I always love when games have little details like that, but none of that's going to matter if the game's not good. That's the thing.
You can then choose to go adventures and like exit the Heartlands and start go exploring and go to like PvE adventures that are much more dangerous and like experience PvP when you're outside the valleys and you're basically not protected by
of course I'm judging this and this is just alpha gameplay, so you know I'm just judging what I'm seeing right now, what they're showing off, but that combat didn't look very satisfying. let's look at it again.
When you're outside the valleys.
There's like no oomph to it, you know?
Not protected by the divine peace.
What we have done is harvested a lot of myths and fables from stories around the world and implement them in our own way.
Magic is real. Ghosts are real. The extent of knowledge is not known, and this basically plays onto our built-in instincts as humans.
The game is very much grounded in reality, but the folklore and sort of the legends that you would hear back then in this world, they actually made them real.
Wait. Yeah, the animations are jittery too. I noticed that. So this is, earlier they were talking about how the armor is very historically accurate and they take like, that's like a big thing. But now they're saying like ghosts and magic are real. So maybe like, back then, I do believe that a lot of people did believe in like sort of these myths about magic and ghosts. I do hope there's magic because I play mages. Yeah, I guess that is right. The Witcher is like that, isn't it? I just never thought of The Witcher to be that way, I guess, because it has like, it goes so far into like the fantasy tropes and stuff like that with all kinds of different monsters and beasts. I don't know how subtle in this game the magic and ghosts are going to be.
You know, we like home, we like cozy, but we're still curious about the darkness, you know, and we also want to experience adventure and danger at some time.
There's more in this world than it might seem at first.
It looks good, though.
It also provides this sort of progression into the game, like the further you head out, the increasing the dangers and also the rewards would be.
I think it will take a very long time if you want to really explore everything of the world. But yes, it's going to be super big.
Game looks pretty though. I like it.
For PAX Day, we're using Unreal Engine 5, and this allows us to do incredibly vast worlds in incredible details.
We have this semi-procedural approach where the human makes the interesting and important decisions and then the computer fills out the rest.
So they're doing procedural generation. A lot of games are going this procedural generation route. Starfield is doing that. This game is doing that. I've heard of a few other ones. So I guess just developers are going with procedural generation. When I hear that word, it kind of scares me a little bit, but we'll see how it's implemented, I guess.
You can change things in a really large scale in a matter of seconds.
Striking that right balance between areas that are nice to play in, but have those cool views and epic views of the mountains.
Currently, we're focusing on the PC platform, and we're focusing on launching it on Steam.
Thank God they said that. I was just waiting for, we're going to launch it on PC and mobile.
We're also working on multi-platform. We have the game working for other platforms, and we already have...
Bro, come on, dude.
...prototypes of that, but the current focus is the PC launch on Steam. The ultimate idea is that we want the game to be playable from any device. It's a way to casually engage with the game. You're maybe at work or in the car, and it's very handy to be able to do this from any device, like a mobile device.
I have never owned a gaming PC.
Yeah, we know. You're a girl.
And I have always admired the beautiful worlds that PC players get to experience, and this is my chance, actually, as a more casual gamer, to join in on the fun, together with the core MMO players, having my own little niche thing to do in the world of PAX Day.
So if you like games that look similar, but like never experienced that in the context of MMOs, I'm hoping that this game is going to be the one for you that actually breaks the barrier and you want to join an MMO.
You know, it's both for very casual and very hardcore. And the beauty is when we have these two playstyles meet, that's where the magic happens, because they will need each other.
So experienced players can support new players, and new players can just get new gear and join their friends.
Bro, that ain't how it's gonna work, dude. Experienced players can support new players. Bro. Yeah, right. But that might be how you want it to work. But that ain't how it's gonna work. Yeah, so what I was saying here is, you know, player-to-player interaction, people, you know, more experienced players might help, kind of newbie players. But going out into these PvP areas that are just like full-fledged PvP, most of the time when you see a geared fella, he's gonna kill you, bro. He's probably going to kill you. It's just the way players work, all right? You're going to get ganked a lot when you're a new player.
In an adventure.
As a solo player or as a casual player, you can provide like an incredible amount of value and kind of feed the market in your area, or like find the market that has some kind of need.
Yeah, so he's saying here again, like if you just want to, you know,
be a farmer or traveling merchant or make potions with alchemy. You can find a community or a player built town that needs, hey, we need an alchemist in our town. Is there any alchemists around? And you can kind of go where you're needed and really add value to the town and community.
That is dope, dude.
You don't need to participate in the big drama. But the fact that there is big drama happening in the world gives the world the context. You know, you will see the soldiers, you know, going to war. You will feel it.
Everyone finds a role to play because everyone in the world of Pax Day matters.
That's so cool, dude. And they were talking about on their website how it's going to be completely player-driven, I believe. That's meaning like you can be a crafter and sell armor and stuff like that. And at least that's what I'm assuming it's meaning, and set up shops and stuff.
I got really excited about the game because I ran in the empty world. And I could imagine in my head, like at some point in years to come, all of these buildings will be built by somebody real, like an actual person. And that felt really nice. I want to be part of this building, this crazy world.
I know, I just saw that fucking Thor. Hell yeah. Got out of Thor's.
It's going to be a long journey. We view being the stagehands of PAX Day as being more like a marathon rather than a single performance. And that's kind of the key to standing up a world like this and also creating the team around it.
We are incredibly excited to see how players will build, you know, civilizations up from, you know, the small house into the small villages, into the towns, into the cities, you know, building up the infrastructure for farming and crafting and blacksmithing and alchemy and finding the resources and study the magic.
Seeing things that we haven't even imagined so far.
You know, the hallmark of any good MMO is to have an initial theory of how the game will evolve, but understand completely that the game in 10 years, 20 years, will probably be completely different from the initial game.
Whoa, so players can actually like craft, build buildings and little towns if they want to and stuff like that. Is that what they're saying? Like make your own town and people can come into your town and they'll be like, what? See, that sounds dope. But I've heard that before too, okay? And it doesn't always work out that way. You should always assume that players are going to be the most asshole-ish that they possibly can. Gonna suck if you're actually genuinely passionate about a game you're making and just die. I think that's why a lot of developers just follow trends and follow things that they know are gonna be popular and they're gonna get their monies back. Games are so expensive to make now, at least a lot of them. Developers aren't taking a chance and just making a game that they want to play. And I think that's why like a lot of older games are so good, is because they're so unique. So even if the game isn't necessarily like amazing, it keeps you playing because it's just so unique. And it's, you know, there's so many games from like the 90s and early 2000s that are just, yeah, really good. I liked a lot. Like you could tell these developers are very passionate about making this game, and there's, you know, they're talking from the heart. So I hope their game does good, but I don't know. Especially an MMO game, I feel like you have to have something that really hooks the players and makes them keep playing it.
It's the game of a lifetime.
I believe it's going to be something incredible.
I can't wait for people to play the game and see how they like it.
Yes, I want to see people's faces playing the game and discovering everything that we've prepared for them.
Stage is yours, and we just can't wait to see the world that you make of it.
Man, I hope this game does well, bro. Just seeing their joy on their faces is something the passion they have for this game. It makes me get emotional, dude. We need more developers like this. But you know how they talk with an accent, meaning they're not from America. I swear to God, every game that comes outside of America, the developers are in their minds are in the right place making it. Aside from like gotcha games, maybe that's from like mobile Chinese companies or something like that. But, bro,
So please go to playpaxday.com or find Pax Day on Steam, wishlist us, and we'll begin opening up access for our first wave of testers before too long.
Before too long, I've already applied for the alpha, by the way. So I'm wondering if... they'll allow people to stream the game. Because a lot of people, a lot of developers have that non-disclosure agreement where you can't stream the game or anything like that. But the gameplay they were showing off, I mean, it looks cool, man. I don't know about the combat, but, you know, it is alpha, so.
And the beauty is when we have this.
It looks so fucking good, man. I can't wait for games to actually start using the Unreal Engine 5.
Two playstyles meet. That's where the magic happens, because they will need each other. And the beauty is when we have this.
The light shafts coming through the tree leaves and stuff, it's just dope. There are reflections on the armor.
Want to experience adventure and danger at some time.
There's more in this world than it my team seem at first. And that also provides this sort of progression into the game. Like,
I wonder what nationality they are, or however you say it. Where are they from? They kind of sound like Norwegian, maybe?
Further you head out, the increasing the dangers and the also the rewards would be.
Also, I'm curious as well. Does any games use the Unreal Engine 5? Uh-huh? Fortnite?